Shut up and sit down.
Hey, I'm Simon.
I'm Ellie.
And if you like our silly videos, please remember to like, comment, subscribe, and hit the bell next to the subscribe thing to let you know, because we do this every day.
Every day.
Every day.
And tonight we're having a couple of drinks that are called...
Well, tonight we are returning to an old favorite,
Ooh.
The rum and coke.
The rum and coke. And what are the primary ingredients in this rum and coke?
Well, I can tell you there are two ingredients. The main ingredient is not coke.
Oh, true. Well, we are surprising each other with trailers that the other person has not yet seen.
So what trailer do we have tonight?
Well, tonight we have a trailer for something that I find really perplexing but really intriguing. It's coming to Netflix in January, and it's really the story of a city that we love very much, live very close to, but may as well live 1,000 miles away from during COVID, and told through the lens of a very cynical but very amusing person. Is that intriguing enough for you?
A little bit.
Well, in that case, we're going to check out the trailer, then stick around until the end, because we will let you know what we thought of it. Let's go.
Yes, in the back.
Hey, Fran, I actually never heard of you before.
That's really a good way to break the ice.
Ladies and gentlemen, the one and only Fran Lebowitz.
People frequently are infuriated by me because I'm filled with opinions. In New York, there are... millions of people, and the only person looking where she's going is me. I should write a manifesto, the title of which would be Pretend It's a City. It would take one subway ride for the Dalai Lama to turn into a lunatic, raging person. I'm the only person who's lived in New York as long as I have who has never made a correct real estate decision. Do people buy books here?
At this kiosk, no.
Do you think it's fair to bring a book into Times Square? It's not fair to the books. People want to challenge themselves. I find real life challenging enough.
Does complaining change anything?
Not so far. I mean, of course, I'm a young woman.
So there we go. Pretend It's a City. Basically, Martin Scorsese interviewing Fran Lebowitz about New York City on Netflix on January 8th.
That's so soon.
Yes. Fran Lebowitz, who apparently has an opinion about everything, but apologies for nobody.
Which makes sense. And I have to say, that statement about no one in New York City knows where they're going except me is true for everyone in New York City.
Oh my God.
Everyone sucks.
So for most of our time here, I worked in the middle of Manhattan, and I would get a train into Grand Central Station at rush hour, walk to somewhere else in Midtown through the crowds of tourists. And about a month in, it was around Christmas, I was walking back fairly late in the evening to my train. And there's an elderly lady pushing her way through a crowd of tourists in the middle of Grand Central Station, obviously keen to get to her train, screaming, "Out of my way, morons!" And I remember looking at that lady and thinking, lady, you're in the middle of one of the most iconic buildings in the world, in one of the most iconic cities in the world. Why are you in such a hurry? And about 2 months later, that was me. I was that old lady screaming at people, calling them morons because they walked slightly slower than I wanted to walk through Grand Central. I've literally sprinted to catch trains in Grand Central, just barreling towards, you know, groups of Japanese tourists who I tower over like a looming, sweaty, round giant as they just corral out of the way like bowling pins falling before me. And that becomes normal after a while in Manhattan. Nowhere else in the world does that make sense.
I think one of my favorite things about New York City, when we moved over, it was a long time ago, but also very recently. And it was long enough ago and recently enough that I feel like we're never going to be allowed to call ourselves New Yorkers. But the ultimate moment... when you move to New York, you have to live here. But when you move to New York, the ultimate moment you know when you've made it And you never know why. This isn't something you can do on purpose. You can try. But there is a moment you will reach when you will arrive in New York City. You will walk out of Grand Central Station. And the guys outside with maps offering to take you on a tour won't ask you anything, because they can tell you live there.
Yeah, the same with the guys giving away their CDs that they then want money for, and the creepy 700 Elmos in Times Square who are trying to scout people for photos. There's just a weird limit you reach where they look at the steely look in your eye and they know they do not want to fuck with you.
I don't even know what it is. You can wear the same outfit, you can walk the same way into the same store, as long as it's not the M&M store.
Yeah.
You can, like, you can walk through Grand Central, you can walk through Times Square, you can walk through all of those iconic streets. There reaches a point at your New Yorkerness where those people can tell you're a New Yorker and they won't speak to you.
Yeah.
And that is the true watershed moment. No one will ever acknowledge you as a New Yorker, but that is when you know you've made it.
I think there's something, there's like a proximity alert when you get close to them and they see the way you're walking and they know that if they get in your way, they're getting knocked down. Like, there's no way you're walking around them. You're not going to slow down. You're going straight through them. There's something about the way you walk as a New Yorker that's just intimidating.
So I'm saying it's magic and you're saying there's some reason to it.
Yeah, maybe. Maybe we're not meeting in the middle here. Anyway, what were we talking about? Fran Lebowitz and Martin Scorsese? I actually love documentaries about New York. They get a little bit preachy. They tend to be a bit too gushing about New York. I like the idea because, you know what, I've got to say, I love New York. I love visiting. I love nights out in the city. There's always something happening. But cripplingly expensive, cost 10 times more than anywhere else you could ever go. Like, I go to Los Angeles and it seems cheap compared to New York. It's crazy.
Yeah.
The pace is just relentless and exhausting. And the people are now so young. So very, very young.
And also, for a city that never sleeps, you try getting beer at 4 a.m.
Yeah.
Everything shuts down.
Yeah, when the bars have already kicked you out, it's really difficult to find anywhere to get a beer.
Yeah.
Well, there you go. I guess we are just reminiscing about New York rather than talking about Martin Scorsese and Fran Lebowitz.
I like how we pretend that it's so far away when it's literally a 20-minute train ride. From where we sit right now, we could be in Grand Central in 20 minutes.
You know, the other day I had to drive to my office. It took me 20 minutes to drive, park, and walk to the office. And I didn't see another employee there in a 1,000-person office. Times Square was like a weird, it was like I Am Legend movie, Will Smith. I was driving the Mustang through the middle of Times Square, just echoing through these empty streets. It was eerie.
As it should be.
Yeah, that's true. Good job.
Remain indoors.
Yeah, good job, New Yorkers, at wearing masks and staying indoors.
And relocating to the Hamptons in Connecticut.
Yeah, exactly.
I see you guys. I've seen the real estate listing suddenly shoot up outside the city. My friends are realtors. I know what you guys are doing.
So anyway, January 8th, Martin Scorsese, Fran Lebowitz, and maybe tune back in for a little bit of us talking about New York, because apparently we quite like it.
Let's celebrate the city that we're probably safest avoiding for a bit longer.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, we'll go back there when there's a vaccine, maybe. But you don't need to wait until January 8th or a vaccine to see us again, because we are totally disease-free, mostly, and you can see us every single day. So we will see you next time, friends, on the next Drunk Trailer Ambush.
I'm walking here.
Hey!
Shut up and sit down.